to share a few secrets of Bomjon, because from the very beginning there are always things which only the elite followers are knowing, and he is keeping all these hundreds of thousands of devotees of him and hundreds of foreigners who do not know the secrets. It's like a hierarchy in his cult, and he needs a lot of money, of course, for all his bribes and projects and covering up of his crimes and silencing his victims and witnesses. So he could not afford to share his most deep secrets with the wide public and, of course, the fanatic foreigner followers who are bringing in the money, usually from Singapore, Hong Kong, Thailand, Taiwan, Japan, USA, Canada. Some Europeans also are helping Bomjon. But I think it's, first of all, it's dishonest, but we already know long ago, at least we, the victims, that Bomjon is very dishonest. A criminal is usually dishonest, and that he's lying to us from the beginning. But even if you don't believe me this, then just give a thought about the secrets which I am going to share you, because they should be things which the governments of not only Nepal, because Bomjon is coming to other America, Canada, Australia, Russia, Korea, he is planning to visit many other countries and spread his new movement. I have difficulty to say Dharma and religion because it's exactly the opposite. So I can call his movement only a cult. It's actually a personal cult of his person. It's not a religion as we understand this word. So be careful, because there are very strange things he is planning to do and he is slowly preparing to do. So one of the first very interesting things was the weapons. Yes, Bomjon had always the sword. Even the French media TV was showing in the French documentaries of Bomjon his sword, and no one was specially like surprised or like shocked by seeing a sword nearby a person who is actually claiming he is working for non-violence and world peace in the world. So even me, I knew it, I must admit. We foreigners tend to see his sword only like a symbol, because we do see similar symbolical weapons in the hands of Tibetan gods and bodhisattvas on the tanka paintings, and there are certain tamang healers who use a so-called vajrakila. Vajrakila is also in Tibet. It's like a symbolical sword kind of weapon with which you are supposed to transform negative energies into positive, so it's not to harm anyone's body. So we also somehow had tendency to accept Bomjon's sword, we saw it in the videos already from 2006, as a kind of symbol. He would of course never harm anyone with his sword, because he is after all a Buddha and a Maitreya, and he is bringing peace to the world, we thought. But in reality, Bomjon did use his sword as early as the end of 2006 and beginning of 2007. And I spoke with Anil Khatri from Ratanpuri in 2012, who told me directly, face to face, that Bomjon attacked him by his sword and cut a big part of his flesh. Actually, Bomjon wanted to cut his head, but because the young boy, he managed to move his head, so he managed to cut only a flesh from his body. And then Bomjon, according to Anil, told this guy, Dil Bahadur, to bring him on a motorbike to hospital, as if he woke up from a trance. So yes, Bomjon is unpredictable when he goes into these trances, when he usually uses this sentence, I had to attack them, I had to punish them. So it even psychologically, the Nepalese police, if ever they would investigate, but they would not, they should think about, is this person reliable? Is it, it's an unpredictable machine who is getting into trances when he must attack people, when he must cut people's flesh or attack people with swords, and he must do it. He has this inner drive, he must harm people. I don't know, in my case it was a prolonged and well premeditated and calculated kidnapping and torture, but when I see his other attacks, it's rather like a certain trance he's getting into, and in such an attack against his own family members, his own brother, Ganga, Dil, and other brothers and sisters, had been done by him right after I was deported from Nepal, and his family went to Halkhoriya to question his deed and also to bring out the smallest daughter, Ranjita, who was 13 years at the time, and they didn't want to keep her in such a dangerous place where attacks on followers are happening. They of course thought that it's not from Bomjon but from the evil followers, because it's like manipulated by Bomjon so that the attacks and the negative things are always like he tells it's from the evil followers. So the family came there, mother, sons and daughters of her, to remind Bomjon that it's not okay and just give Ranjita to them and bring away, but he refused. And instead, Bomjon came and a Canadian follower, Devin Bo, sent me an email, and he sent the same email to many, many other people in different versions. So it's his witness account is very authentic. And even former followers who became a little more passive followers after seeing this email had received his email. And he writes he witnessed, but he didn't know who is who, because obviously a foreigner who doesn't speak Nepali, he only sees the action, but he didn't know why, who, what happened. But he was very, very confused from that. You can see it in his email. And what is he saying then? Bomjon and his followers all came with swords on their vests, and actually it was in the open. Followers of just, it was during the Maitri Puja, just after I had been released, and I was not there already kept, it was in April. So I was released in 24th of March, and the family came on the 2nd of April, if I remember, 2012. So the attack of Bomjon was still when some foreigners, followers, were still hanging around, staying in tents in Halkhoriya jungle, just slowly, slowly going home after the puja, the ritual gathering ended. So Devin was still there with some other followers, and they saw with their own eyes how Bomjon was attacking all these people in the public area. So Bomjon's intention is not really to hide his crimes. His intention is to show his crimes and challenge the people and paralyze their conscience so that they accept his brutal attacks, rapes, tortures of other people as part of Dharma. So he attacked with his sword together with his followers Darshan. Devin even knew Darshan personally, so he wrote his name, that there was Darshan and some other followers and monks who came out, rushed out from the jungle against these family members of Bomjon. and attacked them with the swords and threatened with them with the swords. But that time, there were many people around, so Bomjon and his followers did not use the swords, as in Anil Katri's case. They only used the handle of the swords to hit the people. But obviously, the fact that you are attacked with the swords, any part of the sword, it makes a big terror to anyone. And they attacked Ganga, the big brother, Devin is writing because he didn't know his name. And they attacked the other people. And the media is the media is then explaining that this attack was actually on the siblings of Ram Bomjon and even on his female siblings, because he never made any difference between female and young and old and men and women. So he has no problem to attack brutally a woman and especially an old woman. But for some reason he wanted to keep his own mother in illusions, so he only ordered to attack his own mother by other people and lock her up in the house, one of the office houses, cement houses built that time in the Halkhoriya jungle. And he did not, I didn't hear and I didn't see any witness account that Bomjon would attack his own mother, but we don't know, of course, only they know it. And but Darshan, Molam Lama, Balahari Rai and Bed Bahadur and some other Nepalese did attack physically the mother, and Bomjon sent kind of six people to hold her. A very strong woman who is working all her life in the farms, of course, and they could hardly manage her. A very thin woman, but very strong innerly and outerly. I actually like her very much. And they locked her in the house and tortured her. But until now, she is living in the illusion that Bomjon, her son, was not behind this attack, that only the evil committee is behind, and everyone wants to keep her in this illusion because he would be broken down to know the truth anyway. But Bomjon had attacked in the open, in the eyes of other followers, his own brothers and sisters. And interestingly, during this attack in April the 2nd, Asali, who came out now with a witness account that she had been sexually abused in long, many years ago when she was Bomjon's nun, this Asali Lama was also among these siblings attacked, because Asali is actually Bomjon's a kind of cousin. She's a relative of Bomjon. So Bomjon doesn't mind incestual relationships when he was sexually harassing Asali. And Asali was time to time staying with his family in Bomjor, helping them. So probably she was visiting, but because the media, Nepali media, is writing Asali as an interviewed person, and this Asali is saying, if it's the same Asali, of course, there are no photos, she's saying that Bomjon hit her head, but that didn't say anything. You can check in the Nepali media, I think it was Himalayan Times. And so these are the weapons. And then when I was tied by Bomjon on chain 3 months just before this attack in 2012, so I was hearing shooting exercises on a regular basis every day for many hours, very near to my place. And I was, of course, very worried, because I was thinking, okay, so they are going to shoot me. It's a famous, it's a well-known information. Jasbahadur Vaibhav is telling this to all foreigners, or at least he used to tell it, that Vaibhav himself used to be a smuggler during the king's time, so just before the Maoists came, and I think also during the Maoists. And from this smuggling time, he had his friend in politics, Mani Lama, probably because he needed to cover up his smuggling activities. So Mani Lama was his friend from these old heroic times when he was a kind of, as with his own words, a mafia leader. Rajasbahadur Vaiba of Pilwa, an old, now retired, old, he retired, he never worked, but an old man, who a very rich man, who usually is behind all the bribes of, police bribes of Bomjon's cases, which are countless. And so this Baiba, when I was still a beginning follower and I stayed in his house, so at one, 5 months I was staying, at one point he told me that when he was a mafia leader and he had a lot of guns and he killed some people and poached some tigers in the Halkhoriya jungle, so he wanted to finish with this sinful life when he met Bomjon. And so he dedicated his guns to Bomjon and he deposited them into that stupa. There is this, I think it's still standing in Halkhoriya. Bomjon let make like a small stupa, it's Chorten, they call it Chorten. Actually his Patal Gumba, the underground Gumba, underground meditation place, was under this stupa. So it's an interesting setting that you have a Chorten, we are going there and bow there and may put butter lamps and incense sticks and praying there. And actually there are guns deposited in the opening, and there was, of course they were locked, of this Chorten. And under the Chorten there was Bomjon's Patal Gumba, what was actually the place where Bomjon is told to not only sexually harass Asali in something like 2008-2009, but also that is the place where in the beginning when it was just built and he told that he's going to meditate there, he locked up some person, and I still have to translate that video, I have difficulty to translate, it's in Nepali. Some person was locked up there by him and he told that that person is going to be murdered or something like that. So there were strange things happening in that Patal Gumba, which had Jasbadur Vaiba's guns deposited there. And not just his, but he mobilized his other mafia members to just deposit the guns and stop with the sinful deeds.